Welcome to today's math tutorial. We'll be exploring data handling, which helps us organize and interpret information visually. Ready to dive in? Let's start with pictographs. What exactly is a pictograph?
A pictograph uses images or symbols to represent data. For example, if we're counting students in different clubs, we might use icons like stars or circles to show how many students are in each club.
And how do we interpret it?
Each symbol in a pictograph represents a certain quantity. The key, usually found at the bottom, tells you what each symbol stands for. For example, if one icon represents 10 students, three icons would mean 30 students in a particular club.
Next up, bar graphs. How is a bar graph different from a pictograph?
A bar graph uses bars to represent data, with each bar showing the value of a category. Unlike pictographs, bar graphs use the height or length of bars to indicate quantities.
How do we read a bar graph?
First, look at the labels on the x-axis, horizontal, and y-axis, vertical. The x-axis shows categories, while the y-axis shows the values. To interpret, see where the top of each bar reaches on the y-axis to understand the value.
How do we draw our own bar graph?
Start by deciding on categories and values, then label your x and y axis. Choose an appropriate scale on the y axis to fit your data. Next, draw bars for each category based on their values, ensuring each bar's height or length matches the data.
Any tips on making bar graphs clear?
Yes, keep bars evenly spaced and use consistent colors. Also, don't forget a title to show what your graph is about, and a key if necessary.
Moving on to circle graphs or pie charts, what makes a pie chart unique?
A pie chart shows data as parts of a whole, using slices to represent each category. The size of each slice corresponds to the percentage or fraction it represents out of the total.
How do we interpret a pie chart?
First, calculate each category's percentage of the total. Then draw the circle and divide it into slices based on those percentages. Tools like protractors or software can help make the slices accurate.
Thanks for explaining everything so clearly. Data handling seems like a powerful tool. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more math tutorials. See you in the next video.